EA Sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin getting. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
I don't hear somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
Attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin getting. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
It's just a
Nevada. This is the National Football Raiders taking on Aaron Rodgers and the Green Bay Packers.
EA Sports.
Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to Las Vegas, Nevada. The atmosphere here, electric. No matter the venue, the home folks love their silver and black. They are fired up as their Raiders get set to face off with the Green Bay Packers. And off we go from Las Vegas. This taken in at the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Time to see the offense for Green Bay go to work. Aaron Rodgers leading them. What a career it's been. Came into the league back in 2005 as the number 24 pick out of Cal.
I remember watching him in college and seeing a guy that you knew had great potential, but I don't know that anyone knew that we would see how he would blossom as an NFL player who will go down as one of the every angle with terrific mobility, and he knows how to win games, always in contention for a championship.
This is not a sign of what's in store as he has to fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. Rodgers going to give this one to Dillon. Takes this to the 27. Give him 4 yards.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
They fake the give. Now Rodgers. Flushed out right. And he will not make it back to the line of scrimmage as he's going to be taken down. Corey Littleton able to get outside the numbers and drop it for a loss of a yard. But defensively, you really can't script the start much better. You get a three and out and a sack.
Yeah, you're exactly right about that. They kept him short of a first down on first and second down. And then on third down, they pick up a sack. What tremendous momentum for them to start this game.
On the return is Renfrow. Now after the punt on that play, we've got a man down on the field. We'll take a break and get a report from Vegas after this. Starting spot for the Raiders as they come up first and 10 at their 36-yard line. First carry for Josh Jacobs. And the tackle there by Chris Barnes.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
Trying to run for it with Jacobs. And able to pick up the first across midfield to the 47.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
Meanwhile, Carr's throw pulled in by Renfrow. And he's got this down to the 35.
A That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on it and then let him run.
Yeah, he's got some space. Back to the running game with Jacobs. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped him. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
Seventh play of the drive, forthcoming on third and eight. Now Carr. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Tight defense there on third down, but what a product of good coaching and even better execution, because he realized he's in field goal range. No sense forcing anything, and he made sure he didn't.
The kick by Carlson is good, and the Raiders jump out to a 3-0 advantage. They were probably hoping to get him a little bit closer for a shorter field goal, but he was able to get it done from deep.
Nice little tester for him to begin things, huh? I think he was open for a little bit more of a chip shot. Instead, they made him stretch it out a little bit, but he's got to feel great now that he put it through the pipes.
And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. The Packers offense here coming back out for their second drive. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion, guys a little bit jumpy.
But you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into it.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. Now the man from UTEP. This is Aaron Jones. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Corey Littleton there on the tackle.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And he only manages a couple here down to about the 38-yard line. Now it looks like we'll get a timeout, and we will. We've got an injured Packer on the field. We'll take a break and get a report from Vegas after this. So third and two, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. After one on EA Sports. After the run by Jones, here's first and 10. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. That ball is caught. Marquez Valdes-Scantling. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the two.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
Jones. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
Back at the two now. Here's second and goal. Jones again. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. Aaron Jones. Taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Packers have taken the lead. They were able to push him backwards on first down, but this time he forces his way in.
I wonder if he went back to the huddle and said, guys, just a little bit more help, and I can get it done on this. Feeling like he had that opportunity, and he wanted to cash it in.
On is Mason Crosby for the point after. And this is up and good to make it 7-3. So that winds up a seven-play drive all told. And the last play in the drive was a touchdown run by Aaron Jones. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. Second drive of the game coming up for this Las Vegas offense. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. Mm-hmm. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Give him nine there on the first down completion. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. Carr going to give it to Jacobs. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
On first down, they go with Jacobs again. They'll be dropped shy of the 40 despite powering through the tackle. On the tackle that time, Dean Lowry. Coming up on a second and six. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Working the middle here, that's complete to Moreau, the tight end.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw it, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
So after two first downs, they get another here. First and 10 at the 45. On play action, now Carr. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to
a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10. From the gun, it's Carr. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
My first thought is surprise because that's one of the better tight ends around, and I've seen him pull in balls like this before. But how about a little credit to the defense forcing that incompletion?
Throwing his Carr on third down. Packer pressure, and down he goes. And the defense coming through on third down. A loss of seven to bring up fourth. Defense went 3-4. They got some push from the inside.
And this is something in a 3-4 you don't normally get because the nose tackle who got the sack, he's usually responsible or ends up getting double teamed and sometimes triple teamed. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground?
On is the punt team now as this one sent away. They'll call it a punt of 44 yards. The return was for seven. And it'll be Packer football here. First down and 10. Green Bay's offense ready to go again. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline. Because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play. And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. The Raiders going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Rodgers now after the sack. He'll lead the pack up on third and long. Now it's Rodgers. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it.
I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
I think he's a little trigger-happy right there, and it turned into an ill-advised throw into their zone.
We know he has confidence. He'll throw it any place, anytime, anywhere. That time it fell incomplete. On play action, it's Rodgers. Being chased out left. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down. On now is the Packers punter, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And now a low liner. I think he mishit it. Here's Renfro to return. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Raiders will take over now, first and 10. The Raider offense going to head out now late in this first half. And with a little under a minute remaining, we'll see if they want to try to put a drive together, possibly even take the lead here with a touchdown. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Throwing again on second down. Carr, throw right side, going to be caught by Waller. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First down now, but that clock rolling. Carr's throw here into the hands of Jones. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Ahead of the chains now, second and 2. Again, it's Carr. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds. So third and 2, this quite possibly 4 down territory, though, if they're stopped. Now Carr. Able to find Waller, that's complete. And he is going to have the Raiders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game as we send you to our coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome, everyone, to this abridged version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far, and certainly plenty to look forward to as the teams are right back out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
So it's the Packers set to receive the kick. They've got the lead as well as we are underway in the third quarter. Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. The Raider offense ready to go here to start the third quarter. They do trail, but they have a chance to possess the football first to try and do something about it.
And that certainly makes it something of an important drive for them, because is it going to win the game? No, but you have to do something to bring some life to your sideline.
Tackle made by Devondre Campbell.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Carr now to throw. is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. Here's A.J. Cole now as he'll kick it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. And here's Rodgers on the return. A good work bringing that one back as he picks up about 16 on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. So here are the Packers now. They get set for their first possession of half number two. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those.
You're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Jones running on first down, but finding it pretty tough going as he'll get forward for only about three there before he's taken down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Play action. Now it's Rodgers. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
This has certainly been a physical game so far. Limited scoring opportunities for both sides. And there's another chance that goes unfulfilled.
Now a play fake. Rodgers. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
And he doesn't quite make it, taking it with an eyelash. Dropped at the one. 40 yards now on the ground on just seven carries.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Now Rodgers. Caught right side. It's Lewis. A good rally to the football keeps him to only a yard, and it's second down. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. On second and goal, Rodgers got a man open. It's Adams. Touchdown, Green Bay. Devontae Adams there to make the grab. And the Packers add on to their lead. Circle that drive because that might be one to remember. Well executed to give them a little cushion.
Well, let's take it into the boxing ring. You talk about them commanding it, keeping the fight where they wanted to, whether it was in the center of the ring or putting them on the ropes, because it was jab, jab, jab. And finally, the haymaker to put that drive away.
Extra point up and good by Crosby. And that pushes the lead up to 11. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. Here's Las Vegas ready to take the field. Their deficit is 11, 14-3, and needing to get something going here as they come up on first and 10. On the ground, it's Jacobs to start the drive. Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Here's second and 10. They'll stay on the ground with Jacobs. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
Well, They still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
Here's Carr to throw. That's caught by Waller out left side. And he is going to have the Raiders' first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Throwing on first down is Carr. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Edwards. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Final minute now of the third quarter. On second down now, it's Jacobs. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. It's a screen to Richard. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. As they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On first down, Carr. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. Now Carr, after the incomplete pass, brings him up second and 10. Shotgun now for Carr. And he'll find Moreau here. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Again, they'll throw with Carr. And he's unable to haul it in. So it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field. And that brings up fourth. Carlson able to put this one through. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. All right, so they needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a 3-and-out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
And a nice return sets them up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line. The Green Bay offense ready to take over. The field goal we just saw has us now at a 1-score game, and on this side of the football, things are getting pretty tenuous, a little stressful.
Blood pressure up a little bit, you think?
I think up a lot of it.
Could you imagine taking the pulse right now? Might be like a jackhammer out there on that side of the ball, but here's what the deal is. I think what we've observed is a team that's been playing not to lose as opposed to playing to win. And they've got to get back to that, and that means opening things up again, being a little more free in what they're trying to get done on offense.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. And now they're in the hurry up. Now Rodgers on the bootleg. Forced out to his left. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
As soon as I saw him break contain and get outside, my first thought and my eyes gravitated downfield because nowadays, most of these quarterbacks, when they do that, they want the big play downfield. They don't want to throw it short. In this case, he took the shot. It fell incomplete.
And that nearly the pick that they needed.
He couldn't pull it in, though, and it's fourth down.
And Crosby puts it through, and that will extend their lead here to 17-6.
So that's, CD, an important one here in the fourth quarter.
And that importance cannot be overstated. All eyes on both sidelines were staring that one down all the way. The significance is that they made it a two-score game. Still lots of time left to go, but likely that was their goal at the start of the drive. Get 3 points, make it a two-score game, and they were able to get it done.
The Vegas offense ready for their next possession. And the complexion of this one has changed a fair amount. That last field goal made it a two-score game, so they need to get points out of this drive relatively quickly.
Carr and the Raiders come up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Throwing to start the drive. Carr. And some room to maneuver. And all the way down to the 29.
It's a big play there for Vegas.
That was awfully nice. Hit him in stride and off he went. It was almost like the ball hitting him was like him receiving a baton and he was running the anchor leg in a relay race.
So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10.
Meanwhile, Carr's throw taken in by Edwards.
A gain of 6 there on first. Looking to throw again on second down. Carr. Complete to Jones. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
And that one drops down incomplete. Good coverage there. Forced the ball free, and it's second down.
On second and 10. Carr. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up third down.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, it felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Carr. It's a loss of 14 that time, and it'll be fourth down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Raider football as we get you reset. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. The kick by Carlson is good, and that'll make this an 8-point game. So you knew one way or another that they needed the two scores. They get the easy one out of the way. Now they'll get the ball back, hopefully.
Yeah, and the question is, how do you accomplish that? Do you onside kick it? Or since you have all three timeouts, do you kick it deep? To me, I'm playing field position. With all three timeouts, I kick it deep and try and pin them back there.
And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
The Green Bay offense now about ready to take possession here.
And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and 1. They'll go again to Jones. Now the Raiders going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Now Rodgers.
Throw right side, going to be complete to DeGuara.
Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big play there.
He's down, stomped down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. Now the Raiders going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. To throw is Rodgers. Looking deep for Adams. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Extra point try now for Crosby. And the lead is up to 15 now. Five plays there on that drive. And the result, a Green Bay score. Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25. So Carr and the Raiders now down by 15. A minute 25 to play. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. Carr's throw complete here to Waller. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. Carr to throw. Got a man. It's Darren Waller. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Throwing his car. A big play there for the Raiders. And this is caught for a touchdown. So hang on now. Things just got a little bit more interesting here in the final minute.
They absolutely had to take some chance.
And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed. And in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it. They're taking a peek at whether or not those feet were in bounds, and obviously a big call here in the end zone.
And not just the feet. How about the hands? How is the ball possessed while the feet are hopefully getting down in bounds? That's what they're trying to look at.
So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good, as this gets him back within a touchdown and a two-point conversion. So still a small chance here with a little over 30 seconds to go, but they're definitely going to need this one to bounce their way. And this is going to be recovered by the hands team. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They had to go for it with no timeouts remaining, though, now. This one's as good as over.
They gave it an effort. They tried their best, did everything they could to try and get the ball on the onside kick. You're exactly right. They had to try it. It was their only option. And now this game is done. Just take it, kneel, and call it a day.
Dillon now on first and 10.
And he's going to be stopped at about the 37. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2. Rodgers throwing here.
Open man left side. It's the tight end DeGuara.
And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful? You're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point he just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, you go to a zone blitz game. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
So barring something extraordinary here in the closing stages, that field goal should just about put this one on ice.
Yeah, we've got to find two scores. So, you know, we're not going to exactly move it over there yet. It can be done, but boy, it's going to be a little bit of a stretch for them, isn't it?
Yeah, they would have to move incredibly quick and have some luck, too.
Johnson won't return this, and the football will come out to the 25.
One final try now for Carr. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Darnell Savage.
And the Packers come up with a late turnover, but it will probably only matter to the statisticians as this ball game is now officially over.
League, Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
That's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com.
With that, we say so long from Las Vegas.